This SciShow video is supported by Linode. Go to linode.com/scishow for $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Listen, most people are not huge fans of parasites. Whether it's the tongue-replacing kind, the live-in-your-gut-and-eat-your-food kind, or really any of them, they tend to inspire the heebie-jeebies. And more often than not, they do a number on the health of their hosts, so it's hard for us to think of them as a positive influence on the world. But research from 2020 suggests that, thanks to climate change and other factors, overall parasite populations are decreasing, and that could actually be a really bad thing. Parasitism is a way of life, and not limited to any one group of organisms. It's a strategy, not a family. And it's a pretty simple one. If you're living in or on a host and getting your food from their bodies at their expense, you're a parasite. Parasitism is one of the most common life strategies to evolve across a huge range of organisms from the microscopic to many meters long, making it one of the most abundant and hugely diverse forms of life on Earth. Since parasitism has evolved many times over, exactly how each kind does its thing varies. Some parasites live inside their hosts, while others simply latch on. And it gets even more complicated because many parasites require a host in order to grow from an egg to an adult. Plus, some even need more than one host, hopping from species to species depending on the stage of their life cycle. Some even need three separate hosts through their various life stages. And while we may think of them as unwanted in pretty much every scenario, parasites are deeply interwoven into food webs and ecosystems, and their presence can actually be beneficial. These benefits obviously don't apply to the individuals who have parasites, since a higher parasite load is strongly correlated with worse health. But the pressure those parasites put on populations can have really big impacts by keeping ecosystems in check. Take invasive species. Invasive species are really good at taking over ecosystems. It's kind of what they're known for. But it's possible that the reason they don't wreak havoc on the ecosystems where they came from has to do with parasites. Parasites can help prevent any one species from becoming too dominant by keeping their host species' growth at a reasonable level relative to the other organisms in the ecosystem. And escaping their natural parasites might be one of the reasons that some species become invasive in the first place. For example, when left unhampered by the burden of their pesky parasites, European green crabs are able to grow larger and spread more aggressively. So we can kind of think of parasites as helping to keep some species from becoming overbearing in their own environments. Some researchers have also hypothesized that as hosts evolve to outfox their parasites, the selective pressure created by those parasites causes more speciation and diversity, which is beneficial for the ecosystem overall. So the greater the diversity of parasites present, the more stable and resilient ecosystems may become. The problem is, thousands or even millions of parasite species may be at risk of extinction without us even knowing it. And the impact of their disappearance could radiate through their ecosystems in dramatic ways. See, unless the parasites are infecting us or domesticated animals like pets and livestock, we haven't exactly been invested in studying them or their ecological importance. So we have almost no long-term data on parasite population trends other than the ones that affect us. Since most ecological studies tend not to include parasites on the species checklist, they're not even on the radar of most scientists, even those actively studying biodiversity. So even if we wanted to rally around saving the parasites, we're lacking a full understanding of their ecosystem roles and long-term population trends to even know where to start. But we're starting to unravel the mysteries of some of our parasitic pals. A study published in 2023 looked into the long-term changes in parasite populations thanks to their accidental preservation in natural history collections. The study looked at 139 years worth of museum fish specimens from Puget Sound on the northwest coast of the United States. Because the fishes had all been preserved whole and undissected, their parasites were also preserved alongside them, or more accurately, inside them. That meant the researchers could measure the parasite load of the fish populations through time. Looking at 8 fish species, they discovered that the majority of parasite species were dwindling in numbers over time. Specifically, the pickled parasites that required 3 or more hosts as part of their life cycle were considerably worse off, declining in abundance at a rate over 10% every decade. The study also looked at factors that might have most directly impacted these multi-host parasites and found a correlation with sea surface temperature increases. And although other factors likely also influenced this drop in parasite populations, it was found that for every 1 degree Celsius increase of surface temperature, multi-host parasites were diminishing by 38%. Since they can't live without their hosts, if the host species suffers, so do the parasites. And if they require multiple host species for their life cycle, there's a delicate balance to juggle before the whole thing falls apart. Parasites with more complex and specific host relationships appear to take the biggest hit when it comes to overall biodiversity loss and climate change impact. This is bad news for parasites, given that living through multiple hosts is actually a very common strategy for them. They made up 76% of the total parasite diversity found in the Puget Sound fish in the study. And even if a parasite species only has one host, it's still likely to go down with the ship if something happens to that host. One study predicted that if just 5 of North America's carnivores went extinct, they take out 56 parasite species along with them. And seeing as about a quarter of the world's mammals are already listed as threatened, that could mean tens of thousands of parasite species are also threatened. Parasite ecologists have been trying to sound the alarm for decades, and it's about time the rest of us start worrying about their decline too. In 2020, a group of researchers developed a global conservation plan for parasites to help guide efforts over the coming decade, from increasing education to pinpointing where to focus research efforts and legal protections. And don't worry, these researchers are not advocating for saving our parasites, just the species with non-human hosts. Parasites aren't exactly built for cute logos or cheerful conservation slogans, so it's tough to convince people to champion this particular cause. But if we're really going to take biodiversity conservation efforts seriously, there's some PR legwork ahead of us to get people on board with protecting the less glamorous but equally important species too. Thanks for watching this SciShow video, supported by Linode. Linode is a cloud computing company from Akamai that keeps some of the best stuff on the internet running with data centers across the physical world. Because one of the best things about the internet is that it's the World Wide Web. You can access it from all over the place. If your company serves global customers, they will be able to access what they need in all sorts of unexpected locations because the Akamai Global Network reaches over 4,100 locations and 135 countries. There's a core site in Singapore, there's a core site in Mumbai, and they're working to increase those numbers by adding at least a dozen more data centers by the end of 2023. You can get going with those brand new servers by clicking the link in the description down below or heading to linode.com/scishow for a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Thanks for watching from all over the world.